correct.
Why do we have to fill in a telephone and an email address on the form?
So that we may chase you.
If you don't want to be chased, you like to be free.
That is not freedom. If you like to be free, you would anyway block the number or put the email in spam. See, when one is so habituated to what one is doing, as you said, you are and everybody else is, then the truth is never attractive. When the false has become a habit, then the truth would never be a choice. Never a choice. It has to then come as a matter of grace. It has to then come through your own means and methods.
But I would probably come here anyway for satsang.
It doesn't happen that way.
For me it does.
See, there are so many others. With all respect for your intention, there are so many people who come every day. In fact, this is a smaller audience tonight. Usually there are 35 to 40 people or even 45. And if you read what they say after the session, gratitude, we loved it, this and that. And what happens then? Do you think most of them return? Only 1/3. In spite of all the good intentions, there is something else that carries them away. When they are here, then they have all the good intentions to return. But when they go out into the world, something else becomes more important. That happens. I see that happening every day.
So then you would, then somebody would be emailing and telephoning?
Simple.
Us?
No, not telephoning, but emailing. Telephone is usually there to inform you if something regarding this is happening. For example, we would be sending messages to all those who came regarding the alternate arrangement tomorrow. This needs to be informed to everybody. So a message would go that you can come to the place and somebody will guide you to the next thing. That kind of thing. We send awareness mails. You talked of scriptures. We send awareness mails that contain snippets from scriptures or a shlok from, I talked of Ashtavakra and you said you don't know Ashtavakra. Now how do I bring Ashtavakra to you? The only way is I pick up a shlok from Ashtavakra, I explain it, and I send that as an email to you. How would you ever freely choose Ashtavakra when you do not even know the name of Ashtavakra? Tell me. And you are saying, no, I'll choose freely. You do not even know the name of Ashtavakra. How will you choose him? So that is why we take the emails. So that we can bring something to you to which you are not exposed at all. Not exposed even to the extent that you can make a choice. And emails and all are very empowered means. If you do not like something, you can always just click a button and send it to spam and you won't receive it anymore. Or unsubscribe and you won't receive it anymore. And when we send these things, it requires effort. It requires certain organization. How are those mails sent? Things like these are recorded. Then somebody sits down to edit the recording. Then somebody sits down to transcribe the whole thing. And then somebody takes that database of emails, copies it there and sends them. You must see the miracle happening. And it's not a paid thing. It's happening. It's happening because it won't ever be chosen. You will only choose that to which you are exposed. You will only choose that which is conventional, which is in circulation. You will choose one of these masters that have become popular these days.